I will present you our approach to diversification task, which consists in a pseudo-relevance feedback diversification perspective. It is based on three main steps. First of all, we select the positive and negative examples. Then we fed them to a hierarchical clustering scheme. After that, we apply a pruning step. Then we perform a diversification scheme, which is achieved by traversing the resulting images, the resulting clusters with respect to the flicker initial ranking. The selection of positive and negative examples, the first step, we have the ranked images according to Flickr, starting from the left side, and we assume that the first retrieved images are relevant, and the very last one are unrelevant. We consider the relevant images as positive examples and unrelevant images as negative examples. Of course, this should not exceed the total number of the retrieved images by Flickr. The next step is to apply hierarchical clustering algorithm to these selected examples. And for a cutting point, we have a dendrogram of classes. I showed in this example, starting from class 1 to class k. In this step, we verify if for each class if it is relevant or unrelevant according to the number of relevant images in that class. So for instance, class 1 is considered relevant because of the images in that class are relevant. But class K is considered unrelevant because it has more unrelevant images than relevant images. So we consider this class as unrelevant. The third step is to apply diversification to the resulting classes. So we have the classes obtained from hierarchical clustering on the columns, starting from class 1 to class N. And we start from the first row by traversing horizontally in order to achieve diversification. So we select the first image from class 1, then the first image from class 2, and so on, until we reach the total number of classes. Then we continue with the second image in class 1, and so on, until we reach the final number of the retrieved images, which is 50. In this respect, we take into account the diversification by traversing on each class and the relevancy by traversing vertically within each class. This is the round-robin approach. So for parametric tunings, for the positive examples, we vary it from 100 to 280 with a step of 20. For negative examples, we vary the number from 0 to 20 with a step of 10. And for the number of classes given by the inconsistency coefficient, from 0.5 to 1.3 with a step of 0.2. So we had a huge number of combinations yielded by these parameters. And we selected on dev set the best combination which yielded the highest F1 metric score. We choose this combination and here we have the results on dev set. We submitted for 5 runs, visual textual, CNN based and credibility descriptors. And we achieved the best F1 metric score for visual and text descriptors. And we also provided a Flickr initial results. As you can see, we are 5% above this initial result in terms of F1 metric score. The combination selected previously was applied on test set. We have obtained this result. The best precision was achieved by using visual descriptors, 0.63. The best cost of recall was achieved by using credibility descriptors, and this yielded also the best F1 metric score. What we noticed is that credibility descriptors didn't perform very well on DevSet, but on TestSet we achieved the best results. Here's a visual example of our results for the Easter eggs query. This is for Flickr initial. We can see that five of the images are not relevant, and we also have some visually redundant images. Our run, best run, performed approximately well in terms of precision and cost of recall. We had only two negative unrelevant images, and the cost of recall was 0.53. We also had some unrelevant images and some redundant images, those marked by the red rectangle. So as a conclusion, we noticed that the credibility information was useful in this context of overall diversification. We achieved the best diversification in run 5 with more than 2% over the other type of descriptors. We also achieved with run 5 the best F1 metric score, 0.57, and which allowed for a better performance over the visual and textual descriptors. So we didn't achieve best performance on DevSet with credibility descriptors, but we achieved the best performing F1 metric score on TestSet. Thank you for your attention.